Hello everyone, this is Amritpal Singh. Welcome to my next video on Apache Mahout. In this video, I'll be talking about how we can implement naive-based theorem on Apache Mahout. The reason I've selected naive-based theorem because I've already have covered in my playlist of Apache Mahout the implementation of clustering recommendation, and the one of the important application of Apache Mahout is classification. So that's the reason that I've chosen the naive-based theorem under the classification. I hope you know that classifications come under the supervised learning. Under the classification, we are having some set of algorithms. One of the popular algorithm that we use today is naive-based. So that's the reason I've decided to make a little video on it, that how one can implement the naive-based theorem on the Apache Mahout using command line. So as I've already opened in front of you the Apache Mahout's official website on which the documentation of naive-based has been given. So I'll be strictly following this page only to implement the same. You can see that naive-based theorem comes under the classification, right? And there are two different versions of naive-based theorem. One is called Bayes theorem, one is called CBS. CBS means complement naive-based. So let me first tell you what's this Bayes here, because I hope if you're from the mathematics background, you know what's the Bayes. Bayes is actually theorem which comes under the probability. For that reason, I've already opened up the page to Google on which when we type Bayes theorem, you get its formula. This is a formula on which Bayes theorem works. PAB, PBA into PA over PB. There we have mentioned that what's A and B, these are events. PAB means probability of A given B is true. It's opposite, and last is that PA, PB means independent probabilities of A and B. So on this theorem, the naive-based has been implemented. So in the case of Apache Mahout, to carry out this experiment, what you need in your laptop, of course you need to have your Java, Hadoop working, and then you must be having installed Mahout. This is a prerequisite of doing this little experiment. So for that particular set of experiment, I have chosen one data set for which I am referring this data set, which is 20 news groups. It is one of the very popular data set for machine learning implementation. And its meaning has been given in the Mahout's website also. You can see 20 news group classification example. So this, the 20 news group data set is a collection of approximate 20,000 news group documents. So what you have to do is, in order to conduct this little practical, we need to have this data set available on your laptop. So for that data set, you need to go to this website. Okay, I'll be putting this link on my official channel page in the description box. And after going to this, you need to download this particular link, 20news-bydate.tar.gz file. This is a zip file which is containing 20 news groups sorted by date, duplicates, and some headers removed. You need to click on this link, right? Okay, so this is about the data set. I hope the things are clear so far. I'm just summarizing. Today we're gonna implement the naive-based theorem, which is nothing but based upon the Bayes theorem of probability. And for this little experiment, you need to have Hadoop, Java, Mahout installed, and we'll be using the this 20 news group data set for this little implementation. And let me tell you one more thing. You must be wondering that what's the difference between this naive-based and complement naive-based. For that reason, I've already opened up the Stack Overflow page where they have explained the difference between these two algorithms. You can see that complement naive-based is a naive-based variant which works well when the classes in the training set are imbalanced. Meaning is, you can see person have given the explanation that one problem is that when one class has more training examples than other, then naive-based select poor weights. This is due to the some other reason. To balance this amount of training examples per estimate, we have made use of the complement class formulation of naive-based. So simple summary of the story is that we use naive-based complement naive-based when we have a classes in the training set are imbalanced. So that reason, in our experiment also we'll be using C naive-based, right? So this is the overview of this today's video. So whatever the links I'm using for today's video, I'll be sharing in the description box. Okay, so let's start with this. First of all, let me tell you that what kind of output you'll be expecting, because the output of the naive-based theorem will be coming in the form of confusion matrix. So let me first tell you what that confusion matrix is all about. For that reason, I have created one document for you in which I'll be explaining all the steps for this little experiment, and I'll be telling you what the meaning of confusion matrix. So let's start my video with this particular topic, confusion matrix, because the results will be available in the confusion matrix form when you implement the this little experiment on your laptop. So first of all, let me tell you what the confusion matrix is all about. It's a matrix of rows and columns in which you'll be getting some answers, right? So how we can interpret that confusion matrix and what the confusion matrix is all about? Let me tell you one example here. In this case, let's suppose we have two columns. In one column we have expected values, and one column we have a predicted values. And this is what was expected. This is what we get from by running some kind of algorithm. Let's suppose we need to find the accuracy of the algorithm. So because the similar results you'll be getting after implementation of the naive. So because in the original example we'll be having a multiple number of columns will be available as answer. So from that example, maybe you'll be finding it hard to understand what this confusion matrix is all about, because it will be n by n confusion matrix. So for better understanding, I have taken this little example in which we'll be forming 2x2 confusion matrix. So learning from this example is more easy than the learning from the actual original answer. That's the reason I have decided to make use of this example in front of you. So in this case, first of all, we are now calculating the accuracy. Accuracy means that how many times we have predicted the right answer. So in this formula we are using is total correct predictions over total predictions made in 200. In this case you can see we got 7 answers right. So 7 by 10 in 200, it means we have an accuracy of 70%. So in this case we have written also that you can see that the man has been classified as man. You can see that in the 3 attempts we have classified men as men, and in the 4 attempts we have classified woman as woman. Because we are having total 7 right answers, so 3 plus 4 is equal to 7. So in the 7 answers that we got in the predicted column, out of which 3 been classified correctly men as men and 4 been correctly classified woman as woman. Okay, so if we go further, you can see that in how many times that men classified as women, twice. You can see that in the first row, we were expecting men, but we got women. So in this way, we got 2 instances in where the men classified as women, and we have 1 instance when women classified as men. So the time has come to form a little matrix in which we are having the men and women on the extremes ends, and we are just putting the values of this 4 here in the matrix. You can see men classified as men is 3, then women classified as woman is 4, and where we have errors, we have written here woman men twice, you can see, and men and women which is misclassified, we have written here 1. And you can see that how to interpret this matrix. I've written the summary of it. The total actual men in the data set is the sum of the values on the men column. This is the men column, so 3 plus 2 5. It means originally we were having 5 instances of men in the original column, 1 2 3 4 5. Similarly, if we read this column of women, it means we are having 5 total instances of women also, right? And how to interpret this the diagonal line? So 3 plus 4 is nothing but the total answer, the total accuracy we got. You see, the correct values are organized in the diagonal line from top left to the bottom right corner. So 3 plus 4 equal to 7, we got 7 as an accurate answer. And last, the more errors were made by predicting men as women than predicting women as men. So in this way, we can interpret this output. The reason why I have discussed this example in front of you, because you'll be getting the answer in the same way. Okay, but in that case, the answer will be in the larger scale. So it's very difficult to interpret that answer. That's the reason I'm discussing from this little example. So let's start how we can do this implementation. For this, we need to follow these 8 steps. So I'll be implementing these steps in front of you. First of all, we need to get the data. I've already got the data. Let me show you the data. I've already got the data on my desktop. This is the zip file I've got. And after extracting, we got this. Right, 20news-bydate, under which we have got the 2 subfolders. One is 20news-bydate-test and one is 20news-bydate-train. So what's the objective is we need to just strictly follow this 8 steps to get this done. So let's start with this. First of all, what we have to do is create a new 20news data directory and unzip the data. First of all, we need to create one folder Okay, let me create a one folder in which we need to place this 20 news data over there. Okay, so what we have to do is, let me go to my this and let me make one directory with the name whatever given in the document file, 20 news data. Okay, so okay, let me do it for you. And this actually this should be of HDFS, so we need to create with the Hadoop command. Hadoop fs hyphen mkdir 20 news data. So I'm working on my home location, so I've done the first step, okay, which is given here, that we need to create a directory. Okay, don't worry, I've already have unzipped the data, so the first step is kind of a done for me. What I'm doing is I'm creating one directory first straight away, and we need to place those folders here. So one thing I want to now tell you how to achieve this, because by default when you get this on your system, this zip file, you get this particular folder, right? And this in this particular folder we are having these two subfolders, and in which we are having 20 subfolders, 20 here and 20 is in the training. So what we have to do is, first of all, we need to merge these 40 folders into 20 folders. Means this is have a 20 folders, and with the same name we have a 20 folders in the training folder. The reason why we are merging, because we need to conduct our experiment on this, because they already have separated these two folders. One is training folder, one is a testing folder. In order to test our Naïve's theorem on it, we need to first merge these folders. Okay, for this what we are doing is, we are first creating one separate directory, normal directory, where we'll be placing our merge folders. You can see here we have written, you will see two folders I've already shown you. Now create another directory called 20 news data all. So we'll be creating one directory with this name, and we need to merge these folders of your training and testing. Okay, so let me first create a directory for you. Okay, with a name, let me copy this name, and we need to create a simple directory, mkdir, then we need to paste it here in this. So we got one directory available over there. So it is empty directory. So what we have to do is, we need to merge the data here. So how we can do it? In my desktop, we got this. Okay, and here we are getting this. So we can do it manually. We need to select all, copy, and we need to go to the home in which I got this 20 news data all, paste it here. Okay, we got 20 folders, and 20 more folders are coming up, which is with the same name. It means then you'll get an error. You'll say that whether you want to merge this or whether you want to replace this, we need to merge this, because this one also of a same name. Copy, home, paste. So you'll get an error that whether you want to merge, yes, click on this, apply, and merge. So what happened here is that initially we were having 40 folders, right? 20 from testing, 20 from training. So what we have done is, we have now this 20 plus 20 becomes only 20, because we have merged these folders together, so that we can conduct our experiment on it to get to so that we want to see that how well my Naïve's will gonna perform on this, that whether it able to correctly classify the data at the last or not. It means we are going in a reverse direction now. Okay, so we got this 20 news data all available, right? Now what we have to do is, we need to now put this data in the HDFS directory. I hope you know the command for this. What we have to do is, we need to run the command, which one? Hadoop fs hyphen mkdir, sorry, hyphen put, which one? 20 news data all. We are need to put in the 20 news data. I hope everything is fine. Press enter. It will take some time, because we are having 11,000 plus files available in those folders. I hope till this point it is fine. So we have done till three steps. First we got unzip the data, and then we have created a new directory in which we have merged two training and testing data together, and then we created a new directory, 20 news data, in which we have to copy this in this. It means 20 news data all has been copied to the 20 news data. So here you have a two options. Either you can do it with a put command, or you can also do with the copy from local. I hope you must be familiar with the basic HDFS commands. Either we can copy the local files into the HDFS using put, or we can use it using the copy from local. Okay, so it'll take little time. So meanwhile, I can discuss next step. The fourth step is we need to convert the raw data into the sequence file. I've already have mentioned this step in the k-means clustering example as well in that video, that we need to convert the raw data, whatever data we have in this 20 news data under which we have this directory, whatever data we have in this directory is a raw data. We need to convert to the sequence file. For better understanding, I have written here everything. The sequence directory command, we need to run this command. I'll be showing you in a while. We'll generate a sequence file from a directory. The sequence files are used in Hadoop. You know that one of the format we use in the Hadoop is sequence file. The sequence file is nothing but a flat file that consists of a binary key value pairs. I hope you know that by default, Hadoop MapReduce also works on a key value pairs only. So we are converting the files into sequence files so that it can be processed on the Hadoop, because you know that Mahout actually works on a top of Hadoop. It means we need to convert the files into sequence files so that it can be processed via Hadoop. For this, like you can see that a lot of examples, lot of options has been given here as well. Let me show you this command, which is the sequence command, which is given here. Sequence file, sequence directory command. They have given all, listed all the options here. If you need more examples, right, you can see all the possible options given on the official website as well. Let me check whether the command has been done. Yes, the command has been done. So we need to run one command. Let me type in for you. The command will be sequence directory. This one. So what we are doing now in this command, you can see in front of you, we are using Mahout keyword space seqdirectory space, it's a keyword to convert from the raw data to the sequence files, space hyphen I meaning is input. Input is whatever data we have inside this HDFS directory, which is in the form of this folder 20 news data all, space O means output. So it will be forming output of a folder of this name, 20 news data seq hyphen out, right? So press enter. So it will be running on the top of Hadoop, so it may take a little time. You can see that behind the scenes MapReduce will be working in a while, right? So you can see here that you'll be finding in front of you MapReduce is working. So based upon your configuration of your laptop, it may, the time varies, right? It may take some like longer time if you have not a good configuration of your laptop. Otherwise, it takes some seconds to perform this converting this raw data into the this one sequence directory. Let me check if everything is fine. In the home, we got this 20 news data. Yes, we got 20 news. Fine, everything is fine. So this command should work. It is taking more time. Yep, it started working. So as I've already said that based upon your laptop's configuration, it may take time. So it is working now. You can see MapReduce is working. Okay, wait for this moment. Okay. You can see that program has took this much of milliseconds. Oh, so it means approximate 1.3 minutes has been taken by this step. So hopefully nowadays it's been executed. Okay, so we are happy till this point. Fine, so we have done the first four steps, right? Next step is to convert the sequence file into the sparse vector. I hope this step was again common between the k-means clustering and this Naïve's theorem, that we need to convert the sequence file into the sparse vector. We need to convert to the numerical format, right? So that my machine can understand. So we are converting this whatever the format we got in the previous step, sequence file, we need to convert to the sparse vector. For that, for using this command, we are, as I've already said, we are having multiple options available, which is listed on the official website of the Apache Mahout. So we are using this command, sequence to sparse. Let me type in the command for you, then I'll discuss what we have in this case. The command is, this is a command, right? The command is mahout space seq2 sparse, this is the keyword, space hyphen i means input. Input is whatever the data we get here. You can see, I can show you one thing. After running the previous command, you should get one this folder in which you get one part file. So this will be acting as my input file in the next step. That's the reason we have written mahout space seq2 sparse. Let me clear the screen so that it will be more visible to you. Okay, the command is, yeah, mahout space seq2 sparse is a keyword, hyphen i means input file. This is the input file we got, okay, which is a part file, space hyphen o. This folder will be created, 20 news data vector form, because we need to convert the sequence file to the vector form, space hyphen l norm. So what is l norm? Nv wt and tfidf I have defined in my document file here. First of all is l norm. L norm is this is for the output vector to be normalized. So it means we are normalizing the values. Next is nv. Nv stands for named vectors. And then next is wt. Wt meaning is what is the kind of weight you're using. So let me discuss this weight meaning. Like the weight concept also we use in the neural networks when we assign some weights. Meaning of weights is that it is a kind of a numerical statistic, just to convey that how important a word in the document is. If a word is having more weight, it means it's having a more priority or more significance, right? And by default we're using here tfidf. You can see in the command we are using tfidf. Tfidf stands for term frequency, inverse document frequency. Here we have two options. Either we can write tfidf or we can use tf. Tf stand for term frequency and tfidf stand for term frequency, inverse document frequency. Actually, it is a numerical statistic that is intended to reflect how important a word is to a document in a collection or corpus. So this is the like kind of a defining that how important a word is in the documents, for so which we are using a weight keyword. I hope everything is fine now. Mahout space sequence to sparse is the keyword, hyphen i means input. This is the input file. I've already shown you this input file. Hyphen o means output. This is the output folder. And this is lnorm means we need to normalize the values. Nv means named vectors. W2 stand for weight. And tfidf is the nothing but term frequency identity, term frequency, inverse document frequency. Here we have two options. Either we can use tfidf or we can use tf. Press enter now. Again, it will take little time to run this command. So we are expecting this folder to be created on the home location, 20 news data vec vec. You can see that it's got started. Again, it is making use of MapReduce behind the scenes. Okay, it's working. It may take some time to run this command. So wait for this output. You'll be getting the vector folder to be created on the home location. So map 100%, yeah, it's working. So wait for a moment. It's a lengthy command, so it may take little time. Again, as I've already said before, that based upon your laptop configuration, the time may varies, but hardly takes some seconds only. Okay, so you can see a lot of things going on behind the scenes. MapReduce is functional right now. Okay. So it shows that program took this much of milliseconds or this much of minute, less than a minute. Now we are expecting one more folder in my location, which is 20 news data vector. So it means we have reached to till this point. We have converted successfully the sequence file into the sparse vector. So last three steps are pending now. Now what we have to do is we need to split the vector into training and testing. Like, you must be wondering that earlier we get the data in the same format, now we are doing the same step again. As I've already said earlier, that earlier we got data separate in a separate folders, training and testing. For intentionally we have merged together so that we can test on our algorithm to check whether my algorithm is classifying the things in a better way or not. That's the reason we are again now splitting the data into two folders, testing folder, training folder, right? Okay, so in this for this particular command, we need to, let me clear the screen again for you. What's the syntax we need to follow? We need to follow this syntax. This one. Okay, you can see this is a lengthy command, so I can tell you what we have in this case. Mahout space split. Split is a keyword for dividing into the training and testing. Hyphen I. I means it's the input file. So what's the input file we are now taking? We are taking this input file. You can see that under this vector, we are taking this one, TF IDF vectors. This folder we will be taking as a input to my next command. Okay. Then hyphen hyphen training output is a keyword. It's a argument. What two folders you will be expected after this after you run this command? One is this 20 news data train and one is 20 news data test. These two folders will be created after this command. This is the test output, means is an argument. Next is random selection PCT40. Meaning is, let I have explained it here. Meaning of this random selection PCT means this divides the percentage of a data into a testing and training data sets. I hope that if you're from a machine learning background, you know that some of the portion we keep it for training, some of the portion we keep it for the testing. So in this case, 40 meaning is that here the 60% is for testing and 40% is for training. This is the meaning of this command which we have listed here, random selection PCT. Next is overwrite. Meaning of overwrite is like if the folder folder of files already existed, we need to replace those files. And last is we have specified sequence files. And we have specified XM. XM stand for execution method. We are following two type of execution methods. One is called sequential. One is called MapReduce. For this, I'm taking you to the on this official document. You can see it here. The testing and classification can be done via MapReduce job or sequentially. Sequentially meaning is without doing the parallel fashion. You know that the MapReduce work in a parallel fashion. It actually make use of a distributed computation. Default option we use is MapReduce. Here in this example, we're using sequentially. That we want to do it sequentially without using MapReduce. Although you have two options available. Either you can use MapReduce or you can use sequentially. Right? So it has been mentioned here in the website as well. We have two methods of execution. One is MapReduce. One is sequential. Sequential meaning is in a serial fashion. MapReduce meaning is it is the we do in a parallel fashion. So we have selected sequentially for this. Okay, so I hope the command is fine now. It is clear. So let me now run this command for you. Okay. So in case if you are facing or if you're feeling that something is not understood, you are most welcome. You can comment on my video to ask your questions. So it is again running MapReduce behind the scenes. And deflate is nothing but a compression algorithm. So we got our answer now. The program took this much of seconds. Okay. So you must be getting two more folders in the same location. Let me show you. One is this one, data train. One is data test, whatever we have specified in the previous command. Okay. So we are now left with the last two steps. Now we need to train the model now and we need to test the model. For training the model, we are using this thing. You can show you. We are using this keyword, Mahout space train NB. Here we can pass this much of arguments. So let me show you the command for training the data. For training the data, we are using train NB command. Yeah, this one. So the command says Mahout space train NB space hyphen I. Hyphen I is taking the input folder as train folder. Hyphen O model. Next we have a label index, right? It's a keyword we're using. And next we are having the OW. OW means overwrite and C means we are using which naive base? C naive base, complementary naive base for this. As I've already told you in the beginning that there is a difference between the naive base and complementary naive base. For this, we are using C stand for, complementary naive base. And everything is defined here, label index we have defined here. That path to store the label index, right? Overwrite meaning is if present, override the output directory before running job. So these are some of the parameters we are passing here. It is given on the official website as well. C means training complementary. Yes, we are training complementary as C, right? So we are using these steps. So please press enter now to run this command. We are now training the data. Whatever the folder we got in the previous step, we are now training the data. it will train the data for me so that we can test in the next step. Okay, it will take a little time now. It's working. You can see a lot of things going on. So it need little patience. So we got answer in this much of time. So it means we got now my training data ready. The last step is to test the data. For testing data, the last step of this algorithm, we need to test. Here we'll be getting answer in the form of confusion matrix. For testing data, we have this thing. Again, Mahout test NB is a keyword, like we have a train NB in the previous command. Hyphen I, now we are taking data test folder into consideration for testing. M model, L label index, OW overwrite, O output. It means we'll be getting this folder as output results. It's my output folder. Again, I'm taking you to the official documentation page. You can check. Everything is available. Input, output, overwrite, M model means path to the model built during training. We're giving the path. Then we're giving label index, path to the location of label index. Right? Everything has been given as per the documentation. So press enter and this will give you the answer. Just wait for a while. And again, here we are expecting the confusion matrix to be created in front of you. Accuracy will be shown. Number of classified items, number of misclassified items will be shown over there. So the reason why I have talking about confusion matrix earlier also that it will be like, you can see now, we got answer. It's a quite a bigger confusion matrix. So it's very difficult to interpret from there. That's the reason I have talked about the confusion matrix in a very early stage of this video so that you can understand. You can see the answer now, what we got as answer. Okay, the standard results is the correctly classified instances is 6862. It means 90% we have correctly classified, 90.87. 9.1246 we have misclassified the instances out of 7551. It means out of 7551, 6862 were properly classified, 6899 was not properly classified, and this is the confusion matrix that we got as an answer. So we have got this much of columns, and you'll be seeing that we'll having the same number of folders whatever we have in the data all directory, the same 20 folders we have got here. And we got this much of statistics we got here. You can see it, 90% accuracy, this much of reliability, precision, recall. So these are the nothing but the parameters of the output. I hope you must have understood from this video that how we can implement the Naïve-based algorithm. Again, I haven't specified any step of my own. It has been given on the official documentation of Apache Mahout. And still, if you have feel something is not understood, please comment on my video. I'll be providing all the links whatever I've used in this video in the description box. So I hope you must have understood. Thanks for watching. See you next video.